So I know I haven't done a pregnancy update in forever. I think the last time I did it was 25 weeks. So now I'm at 37 weeks in 2 days. So it's been a long, long time. And for those of you wondering, I'm just doing this video today without my husband. I usually do it with him, but he's at work and waiting on him to do it, it probably will never get done. So I had to just come on here and just do my 37 week update because literally if I wait on him, I'll already have the baby and you guys will not even know what's going on. Last time, let's see what my notes say. Okay, so the first time I think I did the video, I said that I could not gain more than 15 pounds. I have way past that number. I have gained probably about 30 to 35 pounds. And I feel like I should be mad at myself and beat myself up about it, but I'm really not. My goal was 15 pounds, but I was like, you know what? I'm pregnant. It's not really an excuse to like overeat and do all this, you know, like eat a bunch of bad stuff. But I was like, you know what? Let me just get out of my system now and gain the weight, whatever weight I can. I don't want to gain a whole lot of weight because I know it's harder to get it off after you had the baby. But I was like, let me just, you know, gain the weight and not worry about it too much, not stress about it because stress is really bad for the baby. And so I think I did pretty good. Like last time I was pregnant, I gained over like 50 pounds. So this time is a whole lot better. I haven't gotten any swelling in my feet. Last time I was a swollen mess. And if you ask anybody who remembers me from last time, I was just, everything was just my face. I mean, my face is still swollen right now, but it's, trust me, it's not as bad as last time. My feet haven't swollen. My ankles really haven't swollen at all. My fingers have swollen a little bit. I took off my wedding ring. I actually got it resized last time and I tried to tell the guy to resize it bigger and he was like, no, you don't need to. And I was like, trust me, I need to, but it fits a little snug, but I can still wear it. But when I'm like at home or whatever, I just don't even bother to put it on. Only when I go out, I really put it on. I am so ready for once this baby comes out and I am able to start exercising again and just eating healthy, watching what I eat. I'm really gonna get back to it and get on it. But I'm proud of myself, I really am. I know it sounds crazy, but I really am proud of myself because I thought I was gonna do worse. But thank God that, you know, I haven't had any difficulties, any problems as of yet. My blood pressure is good. Every time I go to the doctor, it's like perfect. So I'm just hoping that I can keep that till the end if I do make it to 40 weeks. As far as symptoms, I don't have heartburn. The baby has been really, 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 really low this entire pregnancy. And I will show you guys my belly in the end, but she's way down, like way down. And they keep saying every time, wow, she's really low. So hopefully when I start pushing, it'll not be hard to push her out. We'll see. But I don't have any heartburn because she's not sitting up like near my diaphragm or I don't know. She's just not sitting up very high. The only thing I really am like complaining about is my back because I can't stand for a long time like to wash dishes and do the stuff that I actually want to do. I can't, like I have to ask my husband to help me because I can't, my back just really hurts. It just really, really hurts. So that's been my only complaint really so far is my back hurting and my feet hurting. Like if I stand for too long or if I walk in the mall, I can't do that because I'll get hot. That's another symptom. I get really, really hot easily. So I've been like opening the windows and putting on the fan and it's cold outside. It's like 20 degrees outside, but I have been going through temperature changes and I'm so excited for when this will be over and I won't have to deal with that anymore. I've been getting Braxton Hicks, and Braxton Hicks is just basically like pre-labor contractions, which prepares you for birth. They're not as intense as real contractions, but you know, you do feel them sometimes, and I've been getting them a whole lot more for the past week. But I'm excited about it because I'm like thinking, okay, if I'm getting this now, that means that I'm really close to going into labor, right? Well, at least that's what I tell myself. Like I'm just ready. Oh, another thing that has been going on is that I have been snoring at night and my doctor says it's perfectly normal in pregnancy. A lot of women, you know, start to snore. It could be different reasons, the weight gain or your nostrils, you just have more inflammation. I have allergies, so my nose has been stuffed up the whole time And, you know, it's not pleasant to my husband, but he understands that I'm pregnant. Sometimes he will go sleep on the couch. I know, it's so terrible. But, you know, sometimes if he usually what he does is he tries to fall asleep before me. That way he can't hear my snoring. That's pretty much it. I've been getting like some baby clothes and stuff like that. Really excited because it's a girl, for those of you who do not know. And I can go buy all these really cute girl clothes because I've always wanted to do that. And because I have a boy already. So I'm really excited about that. But as far as like this pregnancy, I'm literally anticipating I'm going to have a VBAC, because the last time I had a C-section, so I'm going to be doing it vaginally now after a cesarean. I'm really excited about that. I hope everything goes smoothly. If you guys, please pray for me. Pray that everything, you know, goes smoothly and I don't have any complications or anything like that. I mean, whichever way the baby can come out the safest, I will go for that way. That is my 37 week update. I don't think I'm going to be doing another update because nothing is really going to change between now and 40 weeks. But yes, this will be my last update. Next time I will be doing my postpartum updates and showing you guys hopefully the changes that are going to go on after I give birth, and you get to meet little Zara. And that's that. So thank you so much for watching, guys. I will see you on my next video. I do have a lot of tutorials coming up, hair videos, other stuff coming up. Definitely stay tuned for that. I haven't been able to do them because of school and pregnancy and all that, but I'm definitely going to try and get back on it, and I have a couple coming up after this one as well. So definitely stay tuned for that. And if you haven't checked out my vlog channel, definitely check that out. We're going to be vlogging the birth, like the whole process, as much as we can. So if you guys are interested in that, I will link the vlog channel down below so you guys can check it out. That's pretty much it. Oh, and I'm gonna show you my belly now. It is huge. But yeah, anyway, all right, I'll see you next time. Bye. And yes, I have pajama pants on, but this is from the front, and you can see how she's carrying really low, and all my stretch marks from last time. I don't know if I've gotten new stretch marks this time or like stretch marks on top of the old stretch marks, but yes, I have stretch marks and I'm okay with it.